Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 has been in beta for a little while now. We've had a couple releases, and every day people message me and say, when is iOS 15's next beta coming out? When is the final version? So I want to go over the iOS 15 release schedule, and this will be based off what we know from the previous years of iOS 14 and iOS 13 release dates. Also, I want to go over if you should install the beta, since many people ask me that as well, and also what to expect if you do install them. Now, the first thing is, before we get started, if you want to talk about anything I talk about in this video or anything in the previous videos, I have a Discord and Telegram community I'll link in the description below. Also, I was recently on the Appleosophy podcast. Quite a few people wanted to know where to find that, so I'll link that in the description also. Now, the first thing is release schedule. iOS 15 has had kind of an odd release schedule. Previously, with iOS 14, we had an odd year where we had a late release, and then this year we had the release of iOS 15 Beta 1 on the 7th of June. Now, this was earlier than last year, and so we had it on the 7th of June, and then on the 24th, about 17 days later or so, we had Beta 2. Then we had a Beta 2 re-release and public Beta 2, which is really public Beta 1, but they called it public Beta 2 just so the numbers align, and that was released on June 30th. Since then, we have not had an update, and many people are asking, when will the next one be? Well, if we take a look at the iOS 13 releases and the iOS 14 releases, generally we're on a two-week cycle, give or take 1 or 2 days. So as you can see, the iOS 13 release dates, for example, we had a 14-day span, then a 15, then a 15, and then a re-release, and then a 12-day, and then you see it gets a little bit less and less as we get closer down or closer to the final release, and we had a big span with the GM or the final version before it came out to the public. With iOS 14 betas, we had a similar release, 15 days, then 15 days, then 13 days, then 14 days, and then we went down to a closer to a week-by-week schedule. This is what I would expect for iOS 15, since this is pretty consistent if you go back to iOS 12, iOS 11, and so on. So that means we're a few days out now from iOS 15 beta 3, based on this time of the video. That means I would expect it as soon as tomorrow, or it could be the following day. Generally, we're on a two-week cycle, but they did do a re-release, so that means we could wait another week. When we get this next release, we can sort of figure out when we'll have releases after that. I would expect a two-week release, then maybe another two-week release 2 weeks later, and then switch to weekly schedules until the final release, which I believe will be sometime in the third week of September. So September 15th or 16th, for example, somewhere in that time frame based on what we had in the past. Of course, it could be in any one of these dates, but that seems to be pretty typical of what Apple does every single year. So I would think the third week or so of September, we'll see a final release of iOS 15 to the public. Now, of course, Apple can change this up. They've been changing up the release schedule every single year, and this year has been even harder to predict. So they could change it up. They could have three-week schedule release dates between betas. They could have a final release in October. But based off what we've seen every single year, that seems likely. So we should have a release any day now. Now, if they skip this week, we'll have a release next week with betas 2 weeks after that again, based on what we know in the past. So that seems to make sense based on that information. Again, I'm basing this 100% off of what we have from previous versions, because Apple does not tell anyone when to expect these final releases. Now that leads me to, should you install iOS 15 betas? Now I've mentioned this in different update videos, but for those of you wondering if you should try it out, I would say now that we're on the public beta, we're at a little bit more stable point where it's fairly safe to install a beta. However, there's a couple things you should know. For example, you should know that you can't downgrade without a computer. So if you want to go from iOS 15 back to a public version of iOS 14, whether that be iOS 14.7, for example, or 14.6, you'll need to use a computer to do that. So as long as you can do that, and you also have a backup that secures all your data, or you're using iCloud to sync your contacts, then sure, it's fine to do that. But just know what you're getting into. But the overall experience has been fairly stable. I've had a few problems with the beta, and in general, it's been pretty good. Now, what I mean by a few problems is, well, one thing is AirDrop just doesn't seem to work for me very well. I go to AirDrop a photo, for example, it doesn't do anything, even after a reboot. I've been having more and more issues with this lately. With Beta 2 and Beta 2 re-release, for example, it just doesn't seem to work. I actually have to AirDrop it to something with a previous version, and then AirDrop it to other devices. It can receive AirDrops, but I can't AirDrop from the phone for some reason. That's an issue I'm having. I've had a few crashes and resprings. A respring is when the screen goes black and then you've got a little dial spinning in the middle and then it comes back up. I've had a few issues there. I've had a few issues throughout with maybe some widgets not showing up. So if I go over here and, well, this weather widget, for example, some of these widgets just will go blank and not show up until I reboot the phone. Now, none of this hurts my overall usability. All of my apps work, but for some people, banking apps don't work, for example. So if you have some critical banking apps, my banking apps seem to work okay, but some people are not having good luck with those. So if you have things that you're doing that are critical to your phone that you need and you only have one way to access them, and you don't have a computer or an iPad, for example, I might pass on the beta. However, if you know that the apps aren't that critical, you can access them through Safari or something like that, well then sure, go ahead and try it out. Most people that have been using this so far, whether it be older devices such as the iPhone 6S Plus, for example, are having pretty good experiences overall. It's probably the most stable early beta in a very long time, maybe since iOS 12. So the beta is fairly stable this early on. It doesn't seem to crash very often. Some people complain of freezing, for example. So if we scroll through, maybe we go into the control center or we're scrolling through apps, sometimes it will freeze or stutter a little bit, but you can see the overall speed is quite good. There's not really too many issues with this public beta, for example. It seems to be working really, really well. So occasional freezes, and some people are saying that their VPNs are not working. So if you use those and those are critical, keep that in mind. And shortcuts may not work for some people as well. So there's definitely some issues here and there, but it seems to be performing pretty well on older phones. So like I said, this 6S Plus, you can see as I've used it, as I go into different applications, maybe I go to Artists and scroll through, things seem to load pretty quickly compared to iOS 14.6, for example. I'd say it's about the same or maybe even better performance overall. It seems to be performing well, except for when you first boot it up. After the first boot up, maybe a minute later, it's fine, but before that, it can be a little bit slow. We'll go into weather, for example, and you'll see this is working okay, but it's not matching what I have on the other phone, which is connected to the same internet connection. One is telling me 90 degrees, one is telling me 89 for the same location. So there's still a few different bugs throughout. Now, again, for those concerned about battery life overall, battery life may take a hit. Some people say that it's quite good. Some people say that it's bad. For example, for me, battery health has gone down a little bit, but this is not because of the beta. It's just because batteries deteriorate over time. So I'm at 98% after using this every single day since its release, which is quite good. 80% after 2 years is normal. And if we look at yesterday's usage, for example, it's not great. 2 hours and 15 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 48 minutes of screen off time, whether that's playing music or something else. But I used about 60 to 70% of my battery life, and I only got 2 hours of screen on time. Now, the day before, I got about 2 hours, 1 hour and 43 minutes, and I used 40% of my battery. It really depends on what you're doing. So depending on what you're using your phone for, there's definitely some things going on in the background causing this to have poor battery life. About 6 hours is pretty normal. However, I can charge this anytime I need to. I have a charger nearby, I have one in my car, and so it's not a big deal for me. But if you need battery life and it's critical to get you through a day, well then of course I might hold off and not install a beta. So hopefully that helps you decide with that. Your phone may get a little bit warm, so if the phone getting hot is a problem, it may get warm running a beta as it's doing a bunch of things that you may not normally be doing in the background since it is a beta and it's early. So there could be bugs and issues overall. And if you have those issues, just make sure you report them in feedback. If you are running a beta, this helps Apple determine what's going on and then actually be able to fix that specific problem. And sometimes they'll even message you back and let you know what's going on or ask for more info. So you'll see recent activity, inbox, and then all the different bug reports I've supported. So, or I've reported. So they sometimes will contact you back, get more information and work on that bug. So it's a nice way to kind of go back and forth with Apple. If it's a major bug, they'll address it right away. And then they prioritize them based on severity. So it's great to see that. So if you're thinking of going to iOS 15 from an iPhone XR, for example, running iOS 14, the overall experience for a beta is great. You may have some bugs and you may have bad battery life, but in general, it seems to be holding up really well. So hopefully that helps you with the overall release dates. It's a little bit confusing, but I broke it all down from iOS 13 and 14 to give you an idea of what to expect overall with the releases. It can take some time. Apple can change this up. It's not set in stone, and they don't tell anybody when they're coming out. So they generally don't let anybody know. So we just have to wait and see what they do. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.